We have Ian Wagner, who was involved in that pileup, and talk about lucky to be alive. What did you call it, Ian? Alive day number two?
Alive day number two for me. That's the term that we use when you're wounded in Iraq or Afghanistan. We refer to the day that you were wounded, the anniversary of that day, as an alive day.
And this accident occurred like on the ninth anniversary of the event?
Yeah, within 24 hours of the exact moment, 9 years later.
Wow.
Tell us what happened.
Flew in from Nashville and went, and I came up here to attend an ice fishing derby, Family Fun Day, that we do every year, which is a memorial to another soldier who I served with, who was killed in action on February 8th. I borrowed a car and a PA and guitar and everything I needed to play some music, and I was headed up to Bella Brook Vineyards in Hammond, New York, and headed up 81, and all of a sudden, you just couldn't see anymore. The Lake Effect band came in, and there was a tractor trailer up in front of me. I saw headlights pretty close behind me, and next thing I know, that tractor trailer's going off the road, and I managed to get around it, but once I got around it, there was just a wall of cars and trucks just packed in the road like sardines in a can, and wound up hitting that, couldn't avoid it, and then cars behind me just started slamming in, and ultimately a milk truck hit all that and pushed us in real good. And yeah, it was a pretty intense moment, but you know, everybody walked away, and one man had a broken arm that I saw, another had an injury to his leg, a couple of us had cuts on our fingers, and you know, obviously banged up and bruised up, but to consider how many vehicles were involved, you could not be more lucky. It's just amazing to me that everybody walked away from this. So.
Yeah, that is the most amazing part, and thanks, by the way, for sharing the video and the photos, and I just can't imagine how everyone walked away.
Yeah, me neither. And you, now you're a celebrity, because I mean, you shot that video and it was on like national news.
You know, it's just been everywhere. In fact, you know, I mean, I'm getting phone calls from people that represent, you know, like major news networks and LiveLeak.com, and you know, now if only I could get one of my music videos to go that far, I think it would be all right.
So, well, and that's now the challenge you face. You lost all the equipment and everything.
We lost. I'm still looking for the actual total, but I'll tell you, we raised a good amount of money already, and, you know, I just cannot possibly thank everyone enough for that. My buddy Mike, rather than ask me for, you know, like, how are you going to pay me, dude? He made this GoFundMe page, and within 2 days, I mean, I think we've raised pretty close to $3,000.
Wow. Yeah, that's tough when it's somebody else's stuff.
Well, and I was talking to him on Saturday, too, and he said, you know, the car can be replaced, the equipment not so much, but despite all that, you still went up and performed the show.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You know, I was thinking to myself, I come this far, and, you know, I just don't see any reason. I know that we were going to have a good show, and we did, and we packed the place in, and it was just great, you know, and of course there was a TV running in the back, and at one point I improvised a song like, that's me, I'm on TV, and it was a very fun day. I grew up in Fairbanks, Alaska, and I've lived here in the North Country for a decade. I moved to Nashville about 3 months ago. I got down there, and I've worked for Tootsie's. I play at Tootsie's Rippies in Honky Tonk Central on Broadway.
Wow.
And it's just a great gig, and I can't wait to get back down there and play.
Well, that's
get away from the snow and back down to Nashville. I'm just blown away by how many people have reached out to me. It's a very humbling thing, I guess. You know, it's just one of those moments where you realize that humanity is alive and well, and this world is full of good people.